Hello friends, I'm Sanchit. Welcome back to our channel Breathing Space. In this video, I'm going to show you how to transplant your Guldabri from a smaller pot like this to a bigger pot like this. So this is a 6-inch pot which I'm going to use. As you can see, my Guldabris have started to wither off the leaves, and it has outgrown the current pot in which it was grown. So this is a good time to ensure that we transplant this to a bigger pot. So also, what I usually do is all these leaves, the dried leaves, I try to keep it in my pot and not throw it away, because over the period of time they will eventually get decomposed and will act as a slow release fertilizer for my plants also. This is what I'm doing over here as well. If you can see in my newer pot, what I have done is I have kept all the dried leaves over here. It will not only help in proper aeration of the soil, but also it will provide the nutrients after 3 or 4 months to the plants as well. Okay, so this is September end, and an ideal time to transplant your Guldabris, so that by the time winter kicks in November or December, the plant will eventually grow and start giving a lot of beautiful flowers. Okay, so let us begin. So since this is a plastic container, let me quickly tap this soil. My purpose is to keep the root ball intact as much as possible. Here you go. See how the root foundation has occurred. Now, ideally, I would have removed some of the roots from here, but this time around, I'll keep it as it is. I will not touch it too much. The last time I used thermocol, the biggest mistake any gardener can do. Guys, never ever use thermocol. It's eventually a plastic, and it will never decompose and will lie there forever in your plants. So never use thermocol in your pots. Okay, it's not good for your plant's health as well. So I'll just do a small root teasing from the bottom, so that the rooting becomes active. We don't have to do it too much to disturb the overall plant, but just a little bit. And at the same time, I'm removing the thermocol as well. That's it. So now, what I'll do is, I'll just put this into my new container, mix this soil, and just ensure this is in the center for the proper growth. We have around 1 inch gap from the rim to the top of the plant, and I will start pouring in the soil. For the potting mix in winters, what I have done is I have not taken the cocoa peat, because the temperature doesn't go very high and there is always moisture in the northern part of this India. And although we have dew and fog in the night, which eventually helps in watering the plants overnight also. So it's 50% garden soil, 30% my sand to have the effective drainage, and 20% vermicompost or cow dung compost to start off with. And then once the plant starts to grow, I will keep on topping up the compost every 2 weeks. That is why I have kept this space available, so that I can do watering as well, and I can top up the compost also. Okay, just give it a quick tap. So that soil settles down, even it out. Just press it a little bit from your fingers. Also, anytime you transplant any of the plant, you give them enough water to avoid any transplant shock. Now we keep this in shade for at least a week so that my plant get used to the new environment. And then for the second week, we will put it in a semi-shade location, and starting third week, you can put it in the full sunlight. By that time, we'll reach around October mid, and the temperature will also be not too much, and it will help my plant to grow more in the apt temperature. So guys, that's it for this video. Please share the video among your friends, subscribe to the channel. That's really going to help me and going to encourage me to make further videos. Thank you. Bye bye. It's easy.